in regard to white collar crime in Arizona. That is a term that's used to explain crimes that involve theft, and not armed robbery or physical theft such as burglary, but more like theft that's a little more highbrow, if you will. For example, blue collar is usually what a construction worker wears. White collar with a tie is normally what a business person wears. That's why they have the term white collar crime. Most people think of RICO violations, which is the Racketeering Influence Corrupt Organizations Act, or they think of bank mail or wire fraud, things of that nature, embezzlement, etc. But it can also include just simple theft at the workplace. And allegations of theft at the workplace occur all the time. We've had clients who are bank tellers where they were accused of shorting their drawer, only to find out later that we produced video showing that somebody else had access and actually took the money from their drawer rather than that individual teller. We've been able to show that business people who have unscrupulous partners will be tricked into signing loan documents or loan applications where they're avowing that their tax return is accurate for whatever year and that they have a certain number of assets that would justify a bank loan. The problem is most business people, if their partner approaches them and says, hey, this is our old tax return from several years ago, go ahead and sign these documents, we need to get them over to our accountant, they won't question it. And then what happens is unscrupulous business partners will get loans and then steal the money. In fact, we went to trial in the US federal court in the District of Arizona on an $18 million bonding and wire fraud loss with that exact scenario. Our client was innocent, said he didn't know what was going on. His partner and his accountant pled guilty, each got a year in prison, and claimed that our client knew what was going on. That's why they only got a year in prison each, is because they flipped and agreed to testify against our client. After a two-week trial, we got a not guilty in all six counts. He was the largest win for a 10-year period that the U.S. government or the U.S. Attorney's Office experienced in Arizona. And it was very important to show that he was not a bad guy. He was simply the lesser educated of the two partners in the construction company, and that he was taken advantage of. Any good attorney, along with their private investigators and their forensic accountants, will be able to delve into the documents and show that you are actually innocent or that you've been set up, in essence, by unscrupulous partners. If you've been charged with a crime or you're worried that you're about to be charged with a crime, call my office, the Law Offices of David Michael Cantor, at 480-858-0808. Many attorneys claim that they're aggressive. I heard this everywhere. And I finally said, if they're aggressive, what are we? And I came up with Beyond Aggressive. I actually trademarked that in the mid-90s because I thought it applied to us, and I truly believe that. And people will say, what exactly does that mean? I say it means we go to trial more than any other law firm in the state, and I can back that up on our website. We list all the trials where we've gotten complete acquittals, every single charge dismissed, well over 100, or where we've received partial acquittals, knocked down the multitude of charges, and maybe lost on just a couple lower charges. I can back it up. It's on our website with dates, courts, names, you name it, it's there. But give us a call.